we have with us Marijo Moreno Juan, European Project Manager from CeBank. And you are going to talk about DICR, dementia, respect and respite.
That's it.
How did you come up with the partnership?
Well, most of the partners, we knew each other because of previous projects, and we did have a very good experience working together. We had like a kind of same background because we came from working in like kind of social projects, especially in aging projects, and we came up to like a kind of conclusion that one of the weakest group among this aging population are the people with dementia, and that we still had a lot of things to do for this group. So we decided that we wanted to develop a project around dementia, and we came up with this partnership where we are like 9 partners from 6 countries, so we are a quite big partnership.
Wow, okay. Why DICR, a project about dementia?
Well, as you have said, and everybody has said before, we are facing a new situation with this aging population. But it's not only about the percentage of people over 65, because we sometimes we talk about people over 65 as if all were the same, and someone who's 65 has nothing to do with someone who's 95, for example, no?
Of course.
So we have to take into account that we are having like an aging of the aging population. The percentage of people over 80, it's really the one that is percentually increasing the most. And we do know that between 25 and 30% of the people over 80 can suffer some kind of dementia. So we are going to face like a really huge reality with the people with dementia. And dementia is the illness that has like the highest percentage of disability. When someone in a family has a dementia diagnosis, everything changes. Life becomes really complicated for them. So we decided that we wanted to create something that could improve not only the life of people with dementia, but also for the life of their caregivers, because all the family situation really changes quite a lot. Hmm. And that's why we decided to work in a project around dementia.
And what are the main objectives of this project?
Well, first of all, and this is a general objective, but I think it's quite important, we want to contribute somehow to improve the quality of life of people with dementia and their families and caregivers by trying to keep their quality of life longer, the longest time possible. For this, we're going to develop a training course in cognitive stimulation therapy. That is a methodology that has been developed in the United Kingdom, and it has been demonstrated to keep their abilities of people with dementia for a longer time, improve their social skills, they have like more social relations with each other. Using this methodology, we want to approach like a new care model for people with dementia. We want to improve the knowledge of the care professional and non-professional caregivers around dementia, because still we don't have like such a professional knowledge to take care of them. Mm-hmm. And I think those are the main objectives of the project. And most of all, to give, you know, to contribute like in a small piece, but somehow improving their quality of life.
Of course. And how do you want to do these trainings online?
It was supposed to be like this kind of blended learning before all this came up, you know, all this COVID came up, because of previous experiences especially in social projects or projects regarding where aging people is implicated, we realized that only online courses are quite difficult to manage. So we wanted to make like this kind of blended learning with some face-to-face workshops and meetings where they can share their experiences, and then some theoretical online training too.
I think that the groups are little groups, so yep. I think that you can respect the distance, masks, everything.
And I hope that we are supposed to pilot this course by the end of this year, beginning of 2022. So let's hope and finger crossed that we will be able to have the original
plan. We hope so, yes. Thank you very much, Marijo.